welcome to Duanes Rules. Me, Duane, the Boozin blogger, coming at you for Monday, January 24th. During this COVID infestation, lockdown, whatever the hell you want to call it. As always, subscribe to my channel. Why aren't you subscribing to my channel if you haven't already? And then once you subscribe, you... That's right, you share the shit out of my videos. Today we're going to talk about...
Yeah, Breaker 19, this here's a rubber duck. You got a copy on me, Big Ben, come on. Yeah, 10-4, Big Ben, for sure. By golly, it's clean, clear to Flagtown, come on. Yeah, it's a big 10-4 there, Big Ben. Yeah, we definitely got the front door, good buddy. Mercy sakes alive, looks like we got us a convoy.
That's right, folks. Today we're going to talk about the convoy. Isn't that a great song by C.W. McCall? Anyways, so the convoy's coming across. We all know that they're protesting mandated vaccinations for truckers, which is kind of cool that they're fighting this, because I don't believe in the mandated vaccinations either. I believe we should have a choice. But like the Canadian truckers, I kind of... You know, it's kind of weird for me because the Canadian truckers have to be vaccinated to go into the U.S. and the U.S. truckers don't have to be vaccinated to come into Canada. You see the bit of an issue here? Why not be fair all the way across the board? I don't know. And you know what? Truckers in general. I worked in a shipping depot, and I know that I rarely ever saw a driver. So that can't be the thing. They used to come in, drop off, or leave with a load. That's it. Come and go. And so I never really saw them. So there's not much COVID chance there. We're in Canada and they're in the U.S. Wouldn't you want to just get the hell out of Canada because it's so freaking cold? Not to mention, what is the risk by them going to the bathroom or having a shower in the truck stop places where they do these things? I don't think that it's that high. I think the government is honestly trying to do this because they feel that if they give the truckers an exemption, they will have to give exemptions to other people. Maybe. I don't know. Like I said, it's all up in the air. And I'm sitting on the fence totally with this thing. I believe in the vaccine. I've got my vaccine. I'm going to go get a booster. But I also believe in your freedom of choice too, right? So it really is. It's a really hard call for me to pick a side. Right now, though, we've got no food in some of our stores. I guess the meat sections in Brockville Walmart and Kempville Walmart on the weekend were empty. That's not good. So maybe the government will stand up and listen. But like I said, it should be fair across the board between the American truckers and the Canadian truckers. Another funny thing I heard was that Trudeau was going to get their GoFundMe page, take all the proceeds because they're a terrorist organization. I don't think that's true, though. I found one story on Reddit, but it got taken away. And to begin with, remember, Trudeau doesn't take money from terrorists. He gives money to terrorists. Remember Omar Khadr, whatever his name was? Yeah, gave him $10 million. So Trudeau's not one to give the money to take the money from terrorists. He's more to give it to them. So I'm pretty sure that's a false statement, but you never know. I'm going to look into this more. And on Wednesday, we're going to talk about it in my podcast. Until then, take care of yourselves. Get vaccinated. Or don't get vaccinated, whatever. Subscribe to my channel. Can always use more subscribers to share the hell of my videos. Remember the most important thing in life, though. Don't be a fucking asshole! Duane's World.